رمضان يا خير الشهور، يا فضل رحمن غفور، فيك البشائر غيثها يهدي السعادة والسرور. رمضان يا خير الشهور، يا فضل رحمن غفور، فيك البشائر غيثها يهدي السعادة والسرور.
The last year saw one of the biggest crises to face the modern world in the form of the COVID pandemic. This has caused immeasurable loss of life, financial strain, and affected the mental health of millions. The Ahmadiyya Muslim community assessed on every level how it could adapt to this situation and serve the wider community. As such, many initiatives were put into action across the UK and the world to serve humanity. In a normal year, every mosque and center across the UK would have opened up to neighbors and friends and invited them to share food and iftar with us. But in these times, it was not possible. As such, the Big Virtual Iftar initiative was born. The Big Virtual Iftar initiative consisted of live stream events, share iftar, Twitter campaigns, and the Ramadan fasting challenge. During the course of 2021, we have brought to you 5 live stream editions of the Big Virtual Iftar. Let's have a look at some of the key moments or highlights that's happened during Ramadan. Our first big virtual iftar was focused around the theme of freedom of speech, in particular, discussing caricatures of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that were recently shown to students in a school setting.
His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed says, "I do not say that you must legally put restrictions on freedom of speech, but we should realize the importance of peace and the importance of the sentiments of others. If, in your view, the peace of society is the foremost goal, then despite the fact that you have the right to say anything you want, a sane person will think twice before utilizing that right." On another occasion, His Holiness said, "Let it not be that in the name of freedom of speech, the peace of the entire world be destroyed."
Our second big virtual iftar was centered around the theme of the passion to serve humanity. A critical focal point during the month of Ramadan for a Muslim is to serve humanity. As such, the Ahmadiyya Muslim community's humanitarian projects were discussed, such as supplying alternative electricity and fresh drinking water to the remotest parts of Africa, and discussing the work of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community's international charity, Humanity First.
In the last COVID year, from 16th of March to 31st December 2020, I've got this data for you. We've served over 11.3 million meals worldwide. We've operated in 78 countries. This has been delivered by 4,230 volunteers. In addition, we have supported 152 hospitals, provided PPE with 440,000 items, and we have benefited nearly a million people. All of this has been done by voluntary contributions of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community globally and their voluntary hours. And we estimated this to be of the value of about $10 million as of last year.
Our third big virtual iftar was themed around community cohesion through humanitarian service, and particularly focused on the work of the armed forces in response to the COVID pandemic.
When you look at the National Health Service support that we provided, and if you just take a moment, I think, to read the quotes on that slide, you'll get the sense, I hope, that the support we were able to provide to the National Health Service, and this is the front line, as we all know, of the pandemic, and we should all pay tribute to the dedication and sacrifice that our doctors and nurses and paramedics and ambulance drivers and everybody and the ancillary staff and the cleaners and everybody involved in the NHS have provided, but that we were able to provide a really invaluable and appreciated injection of support. And I think both our clinical staff and the general duties personnel that we put into the hospitals provided a real injection of energy and resilience and discipline just at the moment where the National Health Service was under probably its greatest pressure. And I think in that sense and in that role, the interaction that we had with our communities was immense.
And finally, our previous big virtual iftar was dedicated to the excellence of Ramadan. This is manifested in so many different ways, both spiritually and physically, And hopefully you had a chance to see some of the beautiful essence of Ramadan through our last few big virtual iftars.
I'm just going to share with you some of the wonderful hadith, the statements of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, which I like on fasting. He said, whoever does not give up forged, in other words, false speech and evil actions, Allah is not in need of his leaving his food and drink. Another one, when Ramadan begins, the gates of paradise are open. This is something that Muslims feel every Ramadan, that their spiritual practices become much easier. And then finally, whoever established prayers on the night of decree, in other words, a special night in Ramadan for the acceptance of prayers, out of sincere faith and hoping for a reward from God, then all his previous sins will be forgiven. And whoever fasts in the month of Ramadan out of sincere faith and hoping for a reward from Allah, then surely all his previous sins will be forgiven. So that's what I want to leave you with. That's the real reason. We don't fast for the medical benefits, but by Allah's grace, we get the medical benefits also.
The Big Virtual Iftar initiative also consisted of a number of activities apart from the live stream event. Let's take a look at a few of these. The first was the Share Iftar initiative. As we were not able to invite our friends to share with us in the breaking of the fast, we began an initiative to send iftar to our friends, colleagues, and neighbors across the country. From the feedback, it seems that they were a huge fan of our more traditional South Asian cuisines. Next was the National Fasting Challenge. The idea here was to challenge our communities to try and fast for a day, a week, or if they so desire, the month. One of the highlights of the fasting challenge was the participation of over 70 officers from the Surrey Police Force and numerous participants across the armed forces. The feedback we received through this initiative was phenomenal, and we had encouragement groups and chats along the way to support our friends as they gave it a go.
I've taken part today in fasting for Ramadan. First time I've done it. Started with getting up at 3 this morning, a Zoom call at 4, and 12 minutes past 4, that was it. No food or drink all day long. So it's been a long day and I'm feeling quite cold and a bit tired now, but it's given me food for thought. I know one of the reasons for doing it is to think of those who are less fortunate than us, and I'm lucky that at 21 minutes past 8 this evening I'll be able to eat something and drink something, and I'm looking forward to that.
And then there were the lockdown video diaries. This series was a feature we brought back from last year. It allowed our viewers to see what a typical day looks from the viewpoint of a member of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community.
So now I've just prayed my morning prayers, known as the Fajr prayers, and I'm just outside of the mosque, so I will show you the mosque now. Here it is, it's called the Fazl Mosque in London. So people are coming in and out, they're just turning the lights off. And this is the first mosque that was built in London in 1924.
One of the things that I love about Ramadan is that just like the spring, when it comes, you can feel the warmth, which in this case is created by the fasting. No food, no water. But what's really, really nice about it is that there's a vibe in the air. And my day normally starts with prayer. And throughout my day, at some point, I always try to focus on the study of the Holy Quran, which was revealed during this month.
There was also the virtual tour of the mosque. Now, this was a segment we also did last year. However, previously with lockdown restrictions, we were unable to have a host actually walk you through the mosque. It was nice to see our mosque inhabited by people once again, and to see someone actually giving you a tour of the mosque and the complex, and even providing news on our latest extension to the mosque. Hopefully next year we will be giving you that tour in person. Through these initiatives, we have had over 10,000 views of our live streams, over 100 participate in the Ramadan Challenge, and shared hundreds of iftar meals across the country. We certainly hope you've enjoyed watching the Big Virtual Iftar. It has been our pleasure to invite you on a weekly basis and to hear from you all. We look forward to seeing you again next year. And in the meantime, Ramadan Mubarak.